While it may not be traditional or necessary to facet the log, it is a good way to true the log, making it symmetrical and straight. It is much easier to develop the gunwale lines and bow and stern from a faceted, symmetrical log. Basically, the idea is remove the irregularities of the log and reduce it to a 16-sided polygon, similar to a Ticonderoga wooden pencil. Following the guideline of a canoe log requirement, the log length should be about 8 times the diameter of the small end. In this case, the small end diameter was 3 feet, and the log was 26 feet long. After spreading, the length to beam ratio is closer to 7. That will be covered later in the spreading section. The first step is to mark parallel center lines at each end of the log.
My partner down at the other end, she has another stick. Like I said, this is called a winding stick. She'll put her stick, just like I did this one, on the center line, and she'll move that until she can sight down and find out that these are exactly parallel with one another. When they are, we each draw a line up on the end of the log.
Next, lay out a 16-sided polygon on both sides using basic geometry. Start with the smallest end first to establish the usable diameter. Using the established center line, draw a circle just inside the bark edge using the center point of the log. Divide the circle into 16 equal pie slices of 22.5 degrees, each using the established center line as the base. Next, draw lines from the points of intersection of the pie slices with the circle, establishing the 16-sided polygon. Repeat the process on the larger end using the established circle diameter of the small end. The next step of drawing lines along the length of the log to establish the polygon shape or facets is a bit tricky because of the irregularities of the log. It is best done using a device called a rotational string gauge, created by Dick the Archangel and Dwayne Pasco.
So this is, made this at a right angle, bolted at the center point, measures 18 inches from here to here. This is in line with the facet, the first facet that we're going to cut. So we have two strings going from this frame to its partner down at the other end. And you can take a pencil, you can do this either by using a straight edge and putting it up here across the string and then marking it here. But I found that it actually works better just to eyeball across the string.
It is best to not do all the facet lines at once to avoid confusion about which line belongs to which facet. Once the resulting lines for a particular facet are defined, then the material is removed using a saw, an axe, and planer. A chainsaw is the fastest way to cut, cutting into the log every 8 inches or so. But caution is advised to not cut too close to the final facet surface.
On the log, we always go towards the bell, which is the bell. And we go towards the knot from either side. On the inside, we go away from the knots.
On the inside?
Inside of the canoe.
Okay.
An electric planer speeds up the removal of the balance of the material down to the flat surface of the facet. Repeat this process for all 16 facets until you have a 16-sided polygon.